My name is Zach Ramsey, and I attend the Elgin campus. I grew up just a few minutes away from Harvest. We attended church every Sunday at a local church here in Elgin. I did not have a relationship with the Lord. I went to church because that is what we were supposed to do. And if you ever went outside of church early, you'd catch me on the side of the building smoking a cigarette that I lifted off my parents that same morning. I was 14 when my parents got divorced. So in my high school years, I was always looking for the comfort that I needed, and I couldn't find that in any other way other than smoking and drinking. And the party was every day of the week from freshman year through senior year. I met the woman who I thought I would spend the rest of my days with when I was 15 years old. I was in an 8-year relationship that I thought was going just absolutely wonderful, but Christ had no part of it. And with my drug abuse and alcoholism, I was not the best person in the relationship. I slowly got into dealing drugs. There were times where I've been robbed. I have had a couple $1,000s in the truck, guns get drawn, and then I end up with nothing. You never know what's going to happen when you're living that life. My grandma was the only person with a rock solid faith in my life. And she asked about how things were in my relationship. And she had encouraged me to go to Harvest. It wasn't even about going to church whatsoever. It was about going to the Hope groups. And every week, there towards the end of the relationship, things were getting worse and worse. I knew that this would not last anymore. That drove me to a pit of despair. My world came crashing down. I found myself with nowhere else to turn except to what my grandma had always been pushing me to, and that was scripture. I'm a mailman in Elgin. I started walking to work every day down Randall Road. I was listening to the Bible on my way to work. There's nothing else, so why not? What do I have to lose? I just so happened to be Pastor Brett Gilman's mailman. And one day, as I'm opening and shutting mailboxes, I get to Britt's house. Britt walked down to the mailbox, and I'd never spoke to these people a day in my life before. Within just a handful of minutes, I ended up pouring out my life story. I was sitting in a mail truck, bawling. Turned into probably 30 minutes of the best soul care I had probably ever received. Britt told me that he would make sure there was a spot for me at Hope Groups and just asked that I would show up. And I showed up, and my soul needed it very much so. It wasn't until Hope Groups, where I was poured into by great brothers and sisters of Christ, that I actually submitted to the Lord and decided to follow Him and to accept Him as my Lord and Savior. I can't say everything in my life was fixed, but I had Jesus, and there's really not much more that I do need. I have been able to stop smoking marijuana. I quit dealing drugs long ago. I've become a faithful servant. On Sundays, I help out with the parking lot ministry here at church. I also serve on the student ministry team as a student ministry leader. And I've also just recently started helping out with the Harvest Young Adults on the food team. Everything that I've learned since following Christ can be summed up in a handful of verses. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. That's just about all I think anyone really needs to know. The rest is just a blessing to us because God cares for us. He loves us. He wants the best for us. There will be times that come up in your life and throughout your walk where it's like, why did this happen, God? But that's just a trial. It is a test of our faith, whether we are faithful or not. And I really hope you guys can stay strong in the faith because it has saved my life. And I hope to be around for a long time. Hope to see you guys here too.